locals know it as Isla Formosa, the beautiful island. It is one of Asia's little dragons, an economic powerhouse.
This place is full of humanity.
This place
is beautiful. It's beautiful. It has a lot of opportunities, a lot of
possibilities. It's my own paradise.
A small island has preserved so many cultures.
The secret to this island's wealth of history, tradition, and culture lies in the endearing spirit of its people. Join us as we journey with a group of unique individuals to the heart and soul of this island's complex and fast-changing society. Little known outside Asia, it's an island waiting to be discovered. So, where is this place?
Taiwan!
Taiwan.
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 The Taipei 101. As of 2004, the world's tallest building stands testament to Taiwan's newfound confidence. So astonishing is Taiwan's economic growth that it's leapt from poverty to prosperity in less than three decades. Now, after waiting in the wings for years, Taiwan is all set to step onto the world stage. It's a territory steeped in Chinese tradition and one that is changing rapidly. Taiwan is home to the largest collection of Chinese art in the world, the biggest number of Mandarin pop stars in Asia, and in Taipei City, possibly the highest number of scooters per square kilometer in the world. Taiwan's economic success has seen the rise of a new breed of Taiwanese with the freedom to explore their culture. Not just for themselves, but also for the rest of the world to experience. Far from the hectic pace of the city, some Taiwanese are discovering a quieter pace of life in the scenic mountains that fringe Taipei, the capital. Here they practice Tai Chi, martial arts, and strive for inner peace with meditation.
我在印度也待了半年，我发现啊，原来我们不了解自己，甚至不了解自己的起心动念。静坐是一种怎么让自己从一个虚幻的想象当中回到一个如实的真实的生活。生活就是好好的吃个饭，走个路，睡个觉，这些东西真真实实，也它给你一个很大的力量。
Mountains are also home to the drumming monks of Yu Theatre. Using traditional Chinese gongs and drums, Yu Theatre has created a rhythmic modern spectacle that is an amalgam of the spiritual, the martial, and the musical. Yu Theatre was established in 1988 by the once well-known Taiwanese actress Liu Ruoyu.
他们会这样子的称呼我们 drumming monk， 是因为我们打坐的关系，就像说打坐跟打鼓哈，还有打拳，这三件事情是我们的主要的一个训练的方式。那当然，我们从武术跟打坐来打鼓的话，那事实上我们也就有点像这些出家人一样，从这个角度来开始从事我们的击鼓的艺术工作。
它给一个人的身体一个活动的空间，怎么从手跟眼睛、你的腰腿之间，怎么达到一个和谐跟协调的警觉度，才回到内在，达到那个很有精神，达到有功力出来。
我开始创优剧场的时候呢，我就决定先找到大自然，在大自然里面生活，跟你在平地里面生活，跟你在 studio 里面训练，我觉得那个是很不相同的。所以这几件事情应该是影响优人神鼓最主要的元素。
在这个大自然当中，如果一个没有耐心的人，他待不下去，好像什么都没有，没有咖啡厅，也没有电影院，也没有霓虹灯，又没有好听的流行音乐，所以他在这个大自然当中，他每天听什么？虫声、鸟叫声、风声、月亮、阳光。
With acclaimed overseas performances, U Theatre's unique interpretation of the old ways for a modern audience has put Taiwan on the world cultural map.
台湾这个环境，它本身除了当地的原住民之外，它还是一个移民的文化。悠人神鼓是在这个文化当中所出现的一个自己的文化，它不仅仅只属于就是说台湾，它似乎属于这个大中国地区或者大的这个亚洲地区里面的某一种，就是东方人的力量这样子。那可这个东方人的力量，我觉得它就是台湾的。
一个这么小的岛，保存了那么多的文化，这样子，我觉得这是它的包容力。我觉得它的精神像一个海绵体。
来说，我们一个台湾人，他最大的一个特色是什么？就是你很会找到空间，这个样的状态，我们就知道如何去运用这个时代来创造自己，给这个时代它的力量。
Amidst the tides of change, the preservation of culture is very important to the Taiwanese.And it's become this man's personal quest to ensure the traditional values are not lost.
Seven years ago, I was living in the country, and I was living in the country.
Once a successful diamond dealer, Tu Chen Fan gave it all up and made a life-changing decision.
When I was doing business, I was trying to live my life. I was about 20-something years old.就感觉讲，但即马咧过生活，无啥像迄个台湾人的迄个生活。我变头壳内底有真侪问题开始想，台湾的文化强要自证起来。人本来是爱有一丝丝仔证，啊你连迄个证，因为几百年无教育，啊都要无去啊。啊所以，我想讲，无论安怎吼，都一定爱去甲找倒来。
The first task Tu set himself was to build a traditional Taiwanese house. He packed up his diamond business and moved his family out of Taipei City. Tu purchased 8 hectares of the finest countryside in the south of Taiwan, in Taitung. He bought materials from old Taiwanese houses which were earmarked for demolition. The many bits and pieces he needed to construct his house with were very hard to come by.So Tu began collecting antique doors and windows and anything of special significance to the traditional Taiwanese way of life.
我都爱从台湾一四过去看，人若有咧起旧厝的，我都去甲迄个老师傅点仔进，啊，有时啊买一物件啦，啊，去遐甲伊开讲啦，啊，直直甲问，啊，慢慢啊累积即个知识。
Where once was a bare piece of land, now stands 3 elegant brick buildings built in the traditional Taiwanese style. One of these buildings houses a collection that is the outcome of yet another obsession of Tu's. Since his childhood, Tu has had a passion for traditional Taiwanese literature. Tu's library of rare artifacts and priceless books in Taiwanese language and culture is a source of pride and joy.And a valuable link to the past.